Assalamu alaikum.
Hello everyone. Today we are going to have a database management system presentation about hashing techniques. This topic is covered by Rafiq Abul Filat from Palestine and Safwan Al-Surwi from Yemen. We are both studying at the Vrindavan College of MCA in Bangalore, India. The contents that we are going to cover is we'll give you an introduction about hashing as a concept. Then we are going to talk about types of hashing, internal and external. After that, we'll talk about hash function and collision resolution. And after finishing all of this, we are going to talk about external hashing. So let's start with introduction about hashing. What is the meaning of the concept? To understand this, let's have a look inside the dictionary. If you see a hash as a noun, it is a dish of diced or chopped vegetables, making these vegetables into smaller pieces. Then, to hash something as a verb is to chop it into small pieces, make it into hash. The hash concept of computer is a technique for locating data in a file by applying transformation, usually arithmetic, to a key. So in simple words, it's a technique for transform bigger data into small key. This key could be a word or a number, and then using this key to identify that data whenever you require it inside your program. So you will have a hash function, and this hash function will receive a key as an input and will give you the address of the required data that you need inside your program. This is the concept of hashing. Then after that, we are going to talk about an example, and I'll let my friend Rafiq.
A simple example of this, what you are talking about. If you are going to search on some information about one of your friends in the phone, you just use the first letter of his name, and then the system itself starts to looking at the first character that you have used based on a special function that has been used in order to give you only the names that have start with the letter that you are using. So for example, Safwan, we will know who has the first name of S. The transform key is chopping and taking the first letter, as you say, then it will show you the contents that starts with this letter only. Now the question is, why we need this from O? Why we are looking for hashing?
It's about, as we're studying that structure, you have some kinds like array. We are using an array, but the problem with array or the drawbacks that we have is that array can store data but for fixed length. What about if you have an array of 20 elements? Then you suddenly want to store the 22nd element. It's not stored in array. And there is also another organization which is linked list. With linked list, you can store as much as you can, but you have problem. If you search for an element which is at the end of this linked list, then you have to start searching from the beginning, from start, then move node by node till you reach your destination. This is something could exhaust the CPU. That's why there is another technique which is hashing. But first, when adding or setting list for either at array, inserting an element, it could be easy made by inserting this element at the end of the array or at the end of the linked list. It's not that difficult. Searching for an element, this may be a drawback, which is require big O of n. In case that you are using the linear search, which you will start from the beginning, from the first location, till you reach your destination. Or you can make this faster by using the binary search, which would also give you a lot of...
Even though in binary search and in linear search, if we saw that we can see that the linear search, we have to move to edge to each node in the array or in the node in the linked list in order to have the information, so we can have the cardinality or the complexity, let's say, about the linear function is going to be equal to the number of the elements. That is very long if we have a lot of elements. Also, binary search, some will say that the binary search will reduce the amount of the information because it's sometimes searching in a sorted array. But if we have the element that we are going to insert or to search is found on the end of the, at the end of this list, also we will return to the same complexity of the linear search. So it's the same.
We didn't do anything. That's why we must search for another data organization, which is based basically by hashing. Now, the main purpose of using hashing is to provide fast access of record. As our friend Asad said, there is some spanning and unspanning thing. This is also based on hashing technique, which will provide something called the hash field. is the most important thing in our hashing, to have a hash field with each data you are going to store. Then, which hash
field is the same name as hash key.
Then the organization which use this hash key or hash field is called the hash of the hub. We have two types of hashing, which is that one.
We have two types of hashing actually. The first one is internal, the other one is external. As we can say, we can differentiate them based on the way of the storing the information inside the memory or inside the disk itself. The internal is speaking about using the hash table in the memory itself, okay? And where each slot can be hold only one entry. Each location can has only one entry of information. And it's mainly used to internal files, as we say. In particular, it's an array or a record. An array of records, or we can say it's an atlas. An external hash, it's used to records with the disks, because we have some different characteristics of disks different than the memory itself. We will explain this in details later. And each slot of information will be recorded inside the hard disk as the name that called buckets, not as a single field for each one of them. Each bucket can contains also a lot of information inside the same bucket. And each bucket are connected to a key that will point the number of the key, not the address, because there are some hash functions later will be applied to the number of the key that where is the key having that number of this bucket, and then will give me the address exactly in the disk. And used to create the indexes itself.
Okay. Yeah.
This is the hash function.
This is the most important thing that we have in hashing, is to have a kind of function that will find your data according to what hash key you have. This function is called the hash function or randomizing function. It is basically applied to the hash field value of a record and will give you the address of this data that you have stored. Hashing is used as an internal structure within a program whenever a group of records accessible by using value of one field. Then let's have a deep information about hash function. Suppose that you have a hash function in this way. You have your own key. And this is the information that you are going to store. And then it's the number of, let's say, the elements that you have. If we have 10 elements, and for each one of these elements, we need to know in which storing place it is stored. Suppose that we have these elements. We are not clear with you. 31. Then we take this 31, take the mode of it by 10. Because how many numbers we have here is 10. The maximum size of this array is 10. So 31 mod 10 will give you the remainder one. One is the place in which you are going to store this 31. Then you will go to the array in the first position, you will store 31. The same thing you will do for 19. Take the 19 mod 10, your remainder is 10,
nine.
So you will store it in the
nine
last location. You will give your this, which all elements you have. In this case, there is no two elements that are stored in the same place. As you can see, each one of them is taking one place. For 10,000, more 10 is the remainder zero. Is zero. So take this 10,000, store it in the first place at index zero. But what will happen if we have two elements that are stored in the same place, which is called
the collision. In this case, we have something that's called collision. Collision is basically when we have the two elements that have the same remainder after we are applying the hash function itself. In this case, we have to find some way in order to have a way to store this information that have the same location. So, example, the hash function. Let's see the example. First example was not containing any redundancy information, but here we can find 13 and 33 and 53 that have the same remainder, which is 3. In this case, we called it a collision. Now, in order to be able to deal with this case, we have three types of methods or three methods that can be used in order to store this information. First one is open addressing, the other is chaining and the multiple hashing. In open chaining, it's based on the, if we have a memory location, okay, different memory locations, and now in memory location number one, we have information, and location number two, we don't have, and three, we have, like this. Now, in the first information, if we have the data 11 and 21, let's say, both have the modulus is 1. So they are going to be recorded on the first location. Let's see in this, this example, it will be better. Now, the first 10 elements of the array, all of the location are empty. In the next, we have only here some values are recorded in location 5, 7, and 8. Now, if we are going to record the 35, which the remainder of it is 15, 35. So in this case, he will come and he will find that 15 is occupied. So what he will do, he will change the hash function by adding plus 1 to the current location and then apply the hash function again. By 5 plus 1, not 10, will give me 6. That means he will go to the next location. Now after he apply this operation, he has to make a check to ensure that this location is occupied or not. So he will do two things. First, we will increase the value, then he will check if this location is occupied or not. If it's occupied, he will change to move to the other one. He will start to move until he reaches the place that he finds it empty, or he will return again until, if he returns to the same value again after he completes this operation, then he will say that there is no other places to be recorded.
It's like sequential search. So after we store 35,000 bits, we have 15. We come to store it in the position 5, this is occupied. We will search for the next available position. So number 6 is also used, 7 is used, 8 is used, then 9 is empty. We store 25 at 9. We have another one, 75. It's also the remainder is 5. We will start searching from here, it is all occupied. Then 9 plus 1 would 10 to 0. So you will come again to store it at 0. This is called open addressing. And there is an algorithm to do the process. I don't know if we have to present this.
We have to go through this?
This is something sequential. You start from 1, then calculate. If this position is used, then you move to the other one. Something about that search.
When you share people this with everyone.
The second resolution collusion is by using the chaining, the concept of data structure. Here, rather than storing the elements directly in an array, they are using the concept of the linked list to store this data. When your hash function, you can write the same key, then you use different elements, like this. The same example as we have, you have number 4, 19, 18, then you will apply the same hash function. Take the number, move 10, and see if you are going to store it. For number 31, the first one. 31 will store in the first position. So you will take this and store it here. The same process you will do with the other elements. But suppose here that we have another numbers which are not number 31.
13, number 15. Number 13. And 720,
723. Something that ends with 1. Any number that ends with 1. 11, 21, 101. So the remainder will always be 1. So if you come here and you find the first element is occupied, then in the chaining process, you will take an end list to another available location. And you will store your value. If you have a third number that has a collision, then take this number and select this to another place. This algorithm is much easier than the previous one because it is easily linked to the other. Because there is a drawback also with this technique, which is
suppose that if we have the information about the 100 elements that have all the same reminder. In this case, we will record all the information in a linked list, which in this case we have returned to the previous thing that we talked about, which is the linked list, that it's not effective to search or to insert or to delete inside. So in that case, we need to have a solution for the solution itself, which is coming as in the third operation, which is the multiple hashing.
This technique, we are using our first hash function, which is the main hash function. If this main function failed, then you have the option to use a second hash function. Instead of dividing by 10, you may divide by 11. And then, if this second hash function fails, then you can use the open addressing, which is the first division resolution technique, or you can say, go for paired hashing function. You keep doing the same thing. If the main function failed, use another one. If the other one failed, then you either use open addressing or use a third function. If the third function fails, then you are going to repeat the same process. This we call multiple hashing. Then our last topic is about external hashing.
It's not clear very much, but it talks about a hard disk that contains a blocks of information that each one is called bucket. Okay, we can find this information that are connected together even if it can be alone as a single bucket, or it can be a multiple buckets or chain cluster of buckets. Each bucket will contain multiple records of information. Now a bucket is either one disk block, or as we say, it's a cluster of contiguous disk blocks. It can be alone, it can be a cluster of information. It depends on the amount of the information that we are storing. The hashing function maps a key into relative buckets number. As we say that we have the memory locations and then the left, and there is a key comes to points and takes the number of this bucket in order to apply the hash function later in order to give it the specific address. And there's a table that the key is using the file header table to convert these buckets numbers into the corresponding block address. Now, in the case of external hashing, the ability or the probability of having a collision is less than the internal one, because we have the information that has been recorded in a big amount of spaces that will be read, comes in several cases or in rare cases. Okay. So we have to put in our consideration a case that we will have a collision sometimes, even if it's recorded a lot of information, but sometimes the information may exceed the amount that it's been recorded in a cluster or a bucket. So we need to get an understanding how to deal with the collision inside the external hashing.
This is what Tassar talked about, is spamming.
Spam, yes.
Have one if your data is recorded in one block, then you don't have another place. You make a record pointer, which points to another place. Take it to the same thing, to the third one. Keep doing the same thing.
Which will solve the problem of the overflow packets, which is
For each record pointer, we have two fields.
The collision.
One of them is the block address, and the other one is the relative record. So for each one of these, for each one of the record pointer, you will first point to the block address which contains the data, then the second block will point to the specific record in which the data is stored. And this is for the external hashing.
That's it.
Do you need any questions you have with me?
In case of retrieving data, so in the hashing, you said, especially when using the LGMOD, the first hashing technique, how then you retrieve after adding one?
Same way.
You said if it's a cobyte, then you add one, then you do the mode again.
The same example we said, number 5, position 5 is a cobyte.
Yeah.
And we'll make 5 plus 1, 6, mode 10. So it will give you the position 6.
Okay, it was supposed the beginning to be stored in 5 location.
So you start searching from 5, then you find your data.
Okay, then
the same as the last element, which is
how I retrieve it then?
You get the
last location.
The address of the location which the data is stored, then you can retrieve. The main idea of hashing is to hash a hash, is to have a hash function, which you give it as input, your hash key, the output will be the address, the location that you have.
Index.
Actually, we want to have a similar exercise. Very, very good presentation. Thank you, Mr. Student. And can we share the PPTs?